Good morning, everybody. Today is Monday, December the 7th, and we are on day 38. And I want you to turn to Mark chapter 7, verses 24 through 30. Now, you may not like this podcast style, so if you're missing seeing my face, here, I'll show you a picture here. A couple pictures of me and my two older kids. Satisfy that? No, okay, I'm just joking. Actually, it is a very quick way to put a video together, and I have been sick, like, for the last several days. And so I'm utilizing this method because of that. So let's go ahead and we're going to pray. And the title of today's lesson is called The Voice of Faith. It is so powerful. I love this story and I think you're going to love it too. But let's pray right now. Lord, thank you so much for this beautiful day that you've made, God. I thank you for every one of these students that's watching. And I pray, God, today that you will open our hearts to this precious word and show us things in this story today, life lessons that we can apply to our own self. And God, let our faith just soar. Believe you for great things. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Mark chapter 7, and we were just covering the last few lessons, the story of how Jesus began to explain what defiles a person, and it all began with, yes, the good old Pharisees and their discussion about what was clean and what was unclean and washing hands and all that kind of stuff. But now we look at verse 24 and it says, "And from thence he arose," which was Jesus, "and went into the borders of Tyre and Sidon and entered into an house and would have no man know it, but he could not be hid." Isn't that interesting? I mean, Jesus is like, he's had all these confrontations. People are seeking him out and he just needs some quiet time. Have you ever experienced that in your own life where you just, like, you just go to your room and you just don't want to talk to nobody? You just need some time to refresh and renew. And I feel like that's where Jesus was at. Even though he was all God, he was still man and he needed rest. He needed quiet time. So verse 25 says, "For a certain woman whose young daughter had an unclean spirit heard of him and came and fell at his feet." So here he is. He's coming to a house trying to get away, but he could not be hid. And this woman found him. She was a desperate mother. And I love the story. It's the desperation of a mom. I know as a mom myself, there is times that my kids have had needs. They've been sick or they have needed, direction in their life. And we take on the burden of our children. And sometimes you have to get desperate before God. And this woman was in that position. Verse 26 says, "The woman was a Greek, a Syrophoenician by nation, and she besought him that he would cast forth the devil out of her daughter." Wow. Can you imagine that? I mean, she had a young daughter that was full of the devil. Can you imagine living with someone like that? And I know you're probably looking around and laughing, thinking maybe it's your brother or sister, but this would definitely be a different story. This girl must have caused her mother complete torment because she had opened up her heart sometime in her life to an unclean spirit, an evil spirit. And we've talked about that before. You have to be careful what you open your heart up to. But the mother was desperate. She needed a miracle. And verse 27 says, "But this is amazing to me because this is so unpredictable of Jesus. I mean, it's like so surprising that he would say this." It says, "But Jesus said unto her, let the children first be filled, for it is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it unto the dogs." Now, what he is saying here, he's saying, she's not a Jew. He came first to the Jewish people and they rejected him. But he's saying, those are the children, and he is calling her a dog. Well, I mean, our first reaction would be like, okay, I'm done. You just call me a dog? No, no way. But what he was really doing is he was trying her faith. He was just seeing, are you willing to move past that comment? Are you willing to press in spite, pressed through that crowd, and she did not care. I love her response. Verse 28 says, "And she answered and said unto him, Yes, Lord. Yet the dogs under the table eat of the children's crumbs." She knew, she identified that she had come out of her dispensation. But the beautiful thing about this is that she accepted the priority of Jesus' mission to the Jews, but pointed out that Israel's privileges did not exclude Gentiles from enjoying the overflow. Isn't that powerful? God's blessing is so vast that the smallest fraction of it is satisfying to all of us. And so, verse 29, "And he said unto her, For this saying, Go thy way, the devil is gone out of thy daughter." This is incredible. Jesus saw her faith, reached through those barriers of racial differences and even time and dispensations. Her faith reached through. This is the story of the voice of faith. And he gave her a miracle. Verse 30 says, "And when she was come to her house, she found the devil gone out and her daughter laid upon the bed." It's a powerful, powerful story. In so many ways, we have to understand that the evidence of her encounter was there in that bed, just completely delivered from satanic forces, and the miracle was there. I love this. I love this. The whole story speaks so strongly to us that if we are desperate before Jesus, he will go through racial differences. He'll go through even denominational differences. He'll go to the end of the world because of someone's faith. And we can believe God for great things, even when we may not feel like we have it all together. You know, I know that this Syrophoenician lady, she wasn't in the position for a miracle, but she was desperate enough that Jesus was amazed and blessed by her faith. And I don't know about you, but that's what I want for my life. I want to be able to speak faith in a way and have that desperation and a faith that gets the attention of God for those around me. And so today I'm believing that the Lord is going to give that word of faith that we all need to be able to speak faith. And again, there's times when we have to get desperate before God, but he's there, he's ready to answer, and he is not prejudiced at all. The Bible says he's no respecter of persons. He will come to where we are if we diligently seek him. Well, I hope that blesses you today, and I hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful day. God bless.